We're going to talk about putting images or clip art or pictures into your document. And there's just a few quick hints when you're doing this. There's lots of fancy stuff you can do to it, but if you get down the basics, you won't be fighting with your clip art. I like to always say, especially for a beginning, is to go ahead and get your document typed in, get all that information in, and then go back and add those types of things that you want. Specifically, to add a picture or clip art into my document, I need to use the Insert tab. So just to the right of the Home tab, I'll click Insert. And then notice in the Illustrations group, it has both picture and clip art selected. I'm going to begin with clip art. When I click on that, it brings the clip art task pane on the right-hand side of the screen. Because there are millions of clip art files out there, we need to give it some idea of what type of picture we would like to find. I'm going to say, and I'll click in what to search for, and I'm going to search for an airplane, because that would go good with the document that I'm using. I might want to look and see where it's going to be searching and what type of files it's searching for. You do have drop-down lists of choices here. To see absolutely everything, you might choose everywhere, and then it would see the most choices possible. I'm going to go ahead and say go, and it will begin searching. It is looking online for these pictures. Notice that as I look at this first one and the second one down here, I see a little symbol in the lower left-hand corner of these, which indicates to me that that picture is actually located online and I must have my internet connection working to properly be able to use that. These first two have nothing, which means that they are actually in the computer. And I don't have to do anything special to be able to access or use these. I can scroll down and look at all the images. When I've decided on the one that I want, and I can choose anything, it doesn't matter what I pick here, I can simply click in the middle of that picture to insert it, or there's a drop-down arrow, which if I click on it, I'll get several choices available to me. If I just wanted to insert it in the document, I could do so by clicking Insert from that menu. And the picture's in. Now, pictures don't always go exactly where you want them to. It will insert it where the active cursor is, but it doesn't go exactly where you want, and you just can't worry about that. There's typically, when I put a picture or clip art in, there's two things I always do to it. First is resizing it. Rarely does the picture come in the exact size that you want. When the picture comes in, it does have the sizing handles on the center and on the corners of it. I'm typically going to recommend you use a corner sizing handle because when you do that, it will keep the picture in proportion. So when you get your mouse exactly on that sizing handle, and again, doesn't matter which corner you use, your mouse shape changes to a double arrow. Double arrow does mean resize. If I click and hold and drag straight to the middle of the picture, and you can see the smaller shape appearing, and when I let go, I've resized that picture. So going on the corner, dragging toward the center makes it smaller. Going on a corner, dragging away from the center makes it larger. It does appear to be jumping around, but again, I'm not going to worry about that because the next thing I'm going to do is really what I think is the magic, the secret to working with pictures. And it's kind of something that sounds illogical, but if you can remember that, I think almost any time I'm having any kind of problem with a picture, this is the magic answer, and that is changing what is called the text wrapping. It has to do with how this picture works with the text that's on the page. Right now, it is what's called in line with text. But to do that, we need to find where that setting is. When we inserted the picture, it is a special object. And so when you put special objects in, they typically come with a special button that is added to the ribbon so they have their own ribbon. And in fact, that contextual tab has been added, as is typical with new contextual tabs, on the right-hand side of the ribbon. So if you notice that in the title bar it says Picture Tools, and then I have the Format tab. And in this ribbon are all the things for my picture. As a reminder, if I click off the picture, deactivating it, that tab in the ribbon disappears. So you must have the picture active in order to be able to use the editing choices and find the ribbon for that picture. On the right-hand side is where the text wrapping option is. I'm going to click on it, and I'm just going to choose a basic square from the drop-down list of choices. At this point, it allows the text to squarely flow around the picture, and in addition to that, it will let me move the picture anywhere I want. I can simply go, now notice I'm not using the sizing handles. I'm going right on my picture and just dragging it to the location I want. If I still want to resize the picture, I can. I can move it now. So really, that text wrapping gave me a lot of control over that picture. It does make my text jump around just a little bit as I work with that, but it depends on what I have in there. So I can move it now anywhere I want. The text wrapping gave me control over it. You're going to find that there's many different text wrappings that are listed there, and you'll have to experiment with them to find that they do other special things with your picture too.